Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Reproduction in Plants. In that, we are studying topic Pollen-Pistil interaction. When I say Pollen-Pistil interaction, it means the ability of the pollen grain to go inside the stigma. Stigma is also called as pistil. How pollen grains go inside the stigma and interact with each other. Today we'll be studying that. Pollen pistil interaction. What is this pollen pistil interaction? During the process of fertilization, we all have studied that the pollen grain which is present inside anther goes inside stigma, style and ovary. So during this process of passing of pollen grains through stigma, style and ovary, there is a certain interaction that takes place, and this interaction is pollen pistil interaction. So let us see what this pollen pistil interaction is. Whenever pollen grain goes through stigma, the hollow passage, large number of pollen grains will be going through the stigma, the hollow passage. Now there comes a narrow passage, and this narrow passage is through which there is a production of sugary substance, and this sugary substance is which a pollen grain comes to contact, and now the pollen grain will interact with this sugary substance and will glide and move towards the egg, or you can say the female gametophyte. This is nothing but pollen pistil interaction. So the ability of the stigma, or you can say the pistil, to accept or reject a pollen grain due to continuous interactions between pollen and the pistil or stigma is nothing but pollen pistil interaction. And the major role that is played by is the sugary substance which is produced in style. Along with that, this sugary substance increases the secretion, or you can say it makes the pollen grains more entine or exine, so that it can walk or glide away towards the female gametophyte. And during the process of double fertilization, pollen pistil interaction plays a vital role, since we all know that during double fertilization there are two male gametes, and due to pollen pistil interaction, one male gamete fuses with the egg cell, while as another male gamete forms the endosperm, or you can say the nutrition value, or provides nutrition to the growing gametophyte. Pollen pistil interactions are really very less in hydrophilic plants, or plants which grow under water. In simple language, pollen pistil interaction means interaction between the stigma and the pollen grain. The ability of the stigma or pistil or female gametophyte to accept or to reject the pollen grain is due to continuous interaction between the pollen grain, the male gametophyte and the pistil, or you can say the female passage or stigma. The process of pollen-pistil interaction basically starts when pollen grains forms on the stigma or the female part, and this falling of pollen grains on stigma during the process of fertilization induces the formation of a sugary substance or a waxy-like substance on the stigma or near the place of stigma. Due to the absorption of this sugary substance by the pollen grains, the entine and exine. Now, when I talk about entine and exine, these are both the coverings of pollen grains. They both swell up and they produce the germ pore and pollen tube. And we all know the germ pore and pollen tube are the two pathways or the passages through which both the male gametophyte or both the pollen grains travel into the egg apparatus, where the process of further fertilization will be taking place. So in this way, pollen-pistil interaction enhances the process of fertilization, or it keeps the process of fertilization on track when there are lots of pollen grains there during process of fertilization. Students, in this part of the chapter, we have studied about pollen-pistil interaction. I hope you all are clear with the concept of pollen-pistil interaction. Thank you.